Peace, guys. It's Alana Sarai. I'm coming at you today giving you top 5 tips to never do with your locks if you want to maintain strong, healthy locks. Stay tuned. Jump right in. I got my notes here. Okay, top 5 things that you should never, ever, 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 ever do to your locks. The number one thing is coconut oil. Coconut oil is really, really good for your skin, but for your locks, it's horrible. The number one reason why coconut oil is not good for your locks is because it starts as a liquid and then turns into a solid. So when it's hot, it's good. It's a liquid. But then once it starts to get cold, it starts to, how do I say this, build up in your locks. And it's almost like having wax or like gum in your locks. And it's very hard to remove it. There is certain processes in which you can remove it. But I would recommend never putting coconut oil in your hair to begin with. Which moves me on to, this is all like a number one topic. And then 1A would be stay away from mineral oil. Mineral oil also causes buildup. So anything like Vaseline or the Blue Magic grease, hair grease, or anything like that, stay away from that. Eco Styler Gel works really, really good on natural hair. On locks, it does not. It's just going to flake up in your hair and cause buildup. Any type of waxes, beeswax, curling wax, any type of wax is not good for your hair. That will also cause buildup in your locks. Any type of conditioners, you don't want to use any heavy conditioners or anything really heavy in your hair. And this is all a part of number one. So stay away from, you know, anything that is heavy in your locks. You want to stay closer to light natural products. I recommend using different lighter products, and maybe I'll do a video on specific products that I use for my locks. And this is, I'm not sure if you can see, but these are my locks. And this is 1 year in right now. This is actually my second set of locks. So I combed out my first set and now this is my second set. That's a whole nother video. Number two thing to never do to your locks would be do not over retwist your hair. What do I mean by that? Is when I say some people retwist their hair every day. You want to be professional. You want to make them neat. You want to retwist your hair every day. You want to retwist your hair every week. Do I suggest doing that? No, I do not. Why is that? Is because you will start to make your locks thin out. You're going to start to see inconsistencies in your lock towards it's going to be hard to maintain a thick and full lock because of this constant manipulation that you continue to do to your hair. All right, number three, do not pull your locks too tight into a style. If you go to a salon, just let your stylist know. Like, trust me, I'm a stylist. I'm a loctician. We don't feel offended or anything like that. If you just tell your stylist, like, look, it's a little bit too tight. Can you loosen it up a little bit? That's 100% okay. Because this means that you're guaranteeing to maintain healthy locks moving towards the future. Pulling your locks too tight will cause your edges to break off. Nobody wants locks with no edges, okay? And then it will also cause, you know, just like, you just don't want it. You'll get these bumps around your neck. Everybody knows that too tight hair is not good. Whether you have locks, natural hair, straight hair, whatever you have, wearing styles that are too tight is obviously going to cause breakage. All right, topic number four, I would say, a lot of people like to wear scarves and things on their hair, and that's 100% fine. However, cotton builds up in your locks and causes lint in your locks. So if you're going to put on a head wrap or you want to wrap your hair for any reason, I would suggest always wrapping your hair first in a silk or satin scarf to protect your hair. Okay, and then wrap your cotton scarf over it or whatever cotton if you need to put on a hat because it's cold. I live in Miami. It's always hot here, so I don't have to worry about that. But for the people who live up north, if you need to wear a hat on your head, first wrap it with a satin scarf or a silk bonnet or something with a soft material rather than cotton going straight on your head. Cotton rubbing up against your hair can also cause breakage as well, and it can cause you to collect lint in your hair. Also, if you're wearing like a cotton sweater, a cotton turtleneck, you need on a cotton scarf or anything like that. You can also notice that these back ones right here at the nape of your neck will start to gather some of that lint. So just all together, maybe if you're wearing a turtleneck or a scarf, try to pin that back hair up or something like that so that you can avoid getting lint stuck into your locks. Okay, and the last tip on the top five things to never ever do with your locks is stay away from dust, dirt, and like pollution of any kind if you can. So like if you work, you know, underground or a train, you know, like some sort of mechanic maybe, or maybe construction worker, just try to cover your hair. Okay, men and women included. If you're a man, you can maybe put a do-rag on and then put your worker's hat on or whatever you need. If you know that you're going to be gardening or something like that, cover your hair, okay? Only because locks absorb so much. They absorb a lot of energy and they also absorb a lot of physical things as well, like dust, dirt, pollution in the air and things like that. So you can also, you know, just try to cover your hair if you know you're going to be, you know, like in a sticky situation. Me personally, I just like to keep my silk scarf right here in my bag with me. I just keep it in my purse with me just in case, you know, I feel like, you know, if I feel like I'm going to be getting a little bit dirty or sweaty, if I know I'm going for a jog or anything like that, I'll wrap my hair. If I'm going to a funeral or a hospital or any type of, you know, emotional place, I'll wrap my hair just to protect from the energy that's around or, you know, just to kind of keep my own energy in as well. All right, guys, so that was my top five things that you should never do to your locks. If you'd like to see more of me, and of course you do, right? Okay, then you can just subscribe to my channel below. I will be posting every other day, and I post on all things locks. So if you have any questions or if you'd like to see me do a video on something that's about locks, just put it in the comments below, and I'll be sure to get back to you guys. Thank you.